So you can be seated. You can be seated. My name is Scott Matthews. I'm your campus pastor. It's good to be with you all here and those of you all watching online. You're probably wondering why in the world did we just start a video with the guys in jail dancing to I Will Survive? Well, this is America's Got Talent, obviously, right? No. So this morning, guys, we're actually going to highlight some of the organizations that we support here as a church and some of the things that we're doing as a church. But we just want to highlight all the awesome things that God is doing here in our county and through what we're doing too. And one of them, as you just saw, is the Elkhart County Jail. So I actually sit on the board for the jail, and it is a privilege to be able to come alongside Corey Martin and all those people who pour into those guys. So that is the program ward. Those guys there, they do Bible studies, they do all the yarn that we donated, they help to do that, they make hats and stuff for people. So there's just a lot of good things happening inside the Elkhart County Jail for the glory of God. They're doing baptisms, you guys. People are giving their life to Christ behind bars. And that's important. Come on. Right. So we want to just highlight this morning all the amazing things that God is doing throughout our county, throughout our church, and some of the things that you guys are doing. A lot of you are involved in a lot of the organizations and different ministries that we do here at River Oaks. Some of you, this is new. Some of you, you're going to see videos and you're going to see ministries that you didn't know that we did, that this church has been doing for years. So just kind of sit back, kind of relax. We're going to do some worship. You're going to see a lot of videos, more worship, more videos. But this morning, we just want to highlight all the things that God is doing in and through this church and through all the organizations that we support. So that's what we want to do. We just want to celebrate. All our songs are going to be upbeat. They're going to be bilingual because God is a God for all people. Amen. And we're going to do this. It's going to be a good morning. So take a seat. We got a couple more videos for you guys to watch. And we're just going to glorify God. But before we do that, I'm going to open up with prayer. So let's bow our heads. Heavenly Father, God, I thank you for another day. God, I thank you for all the things you are doing through this church, through our other churches, through the organizations that we support. God, how you're changing lives even behind Elkhart County Jail, and how that's just a small snippet of the amazing things, God, that you're doing. There's so much bad happening right now that we see. But if you look closely, there's a lot of good happening because our God is good. And even while life is crazy, we serve a good God. And God, we just want to just show that to this morning. We want to honor you this morning on all the things that you're doing in and through your people. And as we watch online, as we sit here this morning, help us just celebrate, God, what you are doing. Not what River Oaks is doing, not what any other organization is doing, but God, what you are doing and how you're changing lives in mighty, awesome ways. We love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let's watch the next video.
To tell you about my community group. It's a really cool thing about belonging to River Oaks Church, and we're like a big family, and we get together, total maybe three or four times a month. And we have a meal together sometimes. Sometimes we just get together to hang out. And recently, because of the warm weather, we've been really trying to focus on reaching out into the neighborhood around the new church building here in Elkhart. And we're really excited about it. We love hanging out with the kids, going out and meeting the families in the neighborhood. And one thing I also love about this is that because there's so many of us, and we all know each other, and we've learned to trust each other, we don't all have to be there to make things happen. We can all take turns, we can reach out to each other, pray for each other, we can just get together. And we don't have to worry about things falling apart because we're like this big, connected family. Just to back up a little, I come from a situation where I don't really have a lot of contact with my own family. I've had to move from church to church because of my life and my work, and so I don't have community until I got into this church, and now I really feel like I belong. And the other thing that I love about it is that we're all very committed to bringing people into the kingdom and making Jesus their king. Hey, so our community group, we first started out with the name Roosevelt Community Group because we were trying to work in the Roosevelt Elementary School here in Elkhart, but it was getting to be where communication was breaking down a bit here and there with the school, even though they appreciated us. So then we were thinking, well, let's work with kids somewhere else, and we tried learning from another organization in Elkhart, and we observed what they did, and that really helped us get an idea, is this something we could do? We threw around the ideas helping at Retta, we threw around ideas helping, you know, in other places, but then as it came established that we were going to work here in right around the new church building, we decided, let's try to work with the kids in the neighborhood and reach the families through the kids. So that's kind of where we're at right now. We're still kind of in figuring it out and hoping that this is really the place that we're going to be. But we have met a few people in business who said, hey, we want to take your flyers, your announcements. We'll even let you hand out flyers in front of our store. We'll leave them here on the counter for people to pick up. So we were like, wow, okay, this is cool. And then I even had a father say, we need something for the kids here in this neighborhood.
El rey de gloria, el rey de majestad. Lord, Heavenly Father, I thank you for each person here, each person present. I thank you because you brought them here today to listen to you, to feel your presence and the presence of the Holy Spirit, God. I thank you, and I pray that you just open our hearts, open our minds so that we may receive all your goodness, God. I thank you in your Son's holy name, I pray. Amen.
All right, you can have a seat. Well, Scott said in the welcome, today we are just pausing to celebrate all the good that God has done in and through River Oaks, across our community, and across the globe, actually, today. And so if today feels a little out of place, like, why are we choosing today? Today's actually the first Sunday of a new ministry year. So as we think about our year, if you remember, you just voted on our budget. Today's the first day of the first Sunday of our new budget. And so it's a really good time for us as a church to pause and just look back and thank God for all that he's done in the last year. And so we saw a little bit of what was going on inside of River Oaks here with the baptism video, and as well as hearing from a community group here at Elkhart Campus. But we also, as a church, we support 8 different local agencies across Elkhart County, here in the city of Elkhart, in Goshen, and our ministry philosophy is that if there are organizations in places that they have dedicated their lives to serving the community well, instead of trying to recreate the wheel, we want to support them, and we want to come alongside of them in every way that we can in order to just support them as we try and show compassion, which is part of our mission here at River Oaks, as we try and show compassion here in Elkhart County and across the globe. And so we're going to spend a little bit of time looking at 2 more videos of local agencies that we support here. The first one, First Light Mission, is in Goshen. That's a newer ministry that we've started to support in the last couple years. And then the second one, I think you guys will notice and recognize even some of the people in the video, Church Community Services here in Elkhart County, or the city of Elkhart. So go ahead and check this out.
Hi, I'm Mindy Moorhead. I'm the executive director of First Light Mission. We are a shelter, a homeless shelter for anyone with minor age children and for single females. So River Oaks has purchased us a bed bug heater, which is a heater for all of anything with cloth on them to run through. It kills bed bugs, it kills roaches, anything. And so instead of having us cycle for 6 to 8 hours, we will have one family's load done in 2 hours. And then they have came in and done lots of painting in our brand new facility in our sleeping rooms. So we have seen him in a really big way with our new facility here at Merritt. We've had 3 other sites that fell through at the last minute. We were pretty advanced in plans and they didn't work out. And we had a guest in need of the night school or Merritt services. So when I called, they told me that they were moving, which 100% was a God thing. And then it just all fell into place. So he has been in every detail with this facility. Yes, we actually are going to have a lot of partnership opportunities and going to be opening up more for outside community members too, that maybe don't fit the mold of coming into our program, single men and stuff too, where we will be able to do case management and then have a lot more agencies that can be able to come in and be in-house. So our guests won't have to be transferred to them, which will save us in transportation costs and just having the availability of them having a private place where they can come and meet with our guests.
Thank you.
I'm Keith Sarber. I'm the Executive Director for Church Community Services. We're a local nonprofit, 501c3. We're faith-based, and a part of our mission statement states that we are helping families in Elkhart County weather life storms. So what does that mean? It means financial services, for help with rent, utilities, prescriptions. It means food services, a pantry that's open and serving Elkhart County 3 days a week and one evening. It means a community gardens program, like the community gardens here at River Oaks, but across Elkhart County, we have 23 community gardens. Along with those community gardens, that seed to feed program is Teen Growers. Teen Growers is a teen intern growing program for high school students. And the Soup of Success program, which most people know us from or by, and that is a women's empowerment program. Women who have gone through significant trauma come and reclaim their lives through a series of classroom endeavors and social enterprise, the social enterprise of Soup of Success. So they package soups and cookie mixes, and they make candles and Christmas trees and mittens, and those are marketed and sold across the globe. So we are extraordinarily lucky to have the partnership with River Oaks on a variety of levels. So everyone here has probably seen a garden that's grown and grown and grown on the edge of your campus. And over the course of the last several years, that garden has produced umpteen pounds of produce for our food pantry. And Jim and Dave have that garden running like a well-oiled machine. I was able to participate in some of the setup for the tomato trellises, and the care and thought that's put into the River Oaks garden is incredible, and it shows in the yield of product. So the one fantastic way that you partner with Church Community Services is through your garden, through the seed to feed garden program. That's extraordinary. Some of those folks that are out there in the hot sun in the late afternoons gardening are also board members. Some of the folks that are out there gardening in the late afternoon are also volunteers at Church Community Services. So some of those folks are volunteering to help run the organization, and some of those folks are volunteering to make sure that the products that you're growing are going out to pantry clients on a regular basis. So those are at least three great ways that River Oaks is partnering with Church Community Services. On top of that, there's a regular financial donation that we couldn't survive. We couldn't continue without the generous support of River Oaks congregation. So a lot of people don't know how Church Community Services was founded, and our organization almost 55 years ago was founded by 11 local churches around, in and around the city of Elkhart. And that tradition continues today with incredible partnerships with churches like River Oaks. So how does God continue to show up in the midst of current situations in very providential ways that maybe sometimes are hard or mysterious to explain? One example, just recently, we've seen our USDA commodities decrease, and in particular, decrease in protein. So less meats going out to our client, pantry clients. And what happened within that immediate time frame was a generous donor stepped up to donate up to 3 head of beef, processed, packaged, butchered, processed, and delivered to Church Community Services in 1 and 2 pound packages. That's a great example of how God shows up in the midst of our efforts to try and figure things out. Lots of excitement at Church Community Services. We have structural concerns we'd like to add to our buildings. That's very exciting. A capital campaign maybe in the works. That's very exciting. We'd like to expand seed to feed. We'd love to find some extra farmland to expand that program across the county. And very exciting to offer or have a men's program that complements our Super Success program. So at some point in the near future, you'll be hearing more about that this year. But if there's interest in having the conversation with us about what a great men's program might look like, please don't hesitate to ask.
Speak the whole
It's been good so far this morning to see all that God's doing here in our church and locally in Elkhart County. But a big part of what we do in our heart as a church is also around the globe as well. And so we've really been in the last couple of years leaning into the partnerships and the relationships that are continuing to develop through our Espanol campus. And last I knew, I believe there's 11 different nationalities represented at River Oaks in Espanol, which is pretty exciting. And so as we even think about how do we show compassion and go to our neighbors with the message of Jesus around the globe, those relationships we're really leaning into. And so you're going to see a video here in a minute of some relationships that we've developed down in Venezuela, as well as some new missionaries that we've begun to support in this last year, Mark and Megan Music. Megan's maiden name is Weestock, and actually grew up in our youth group here at River Oaks, and so it's exciting for us to be able to come alongside them and support them in their ministry in London, England, through the EFCA Reach Global program, which is a part of our denomination that we're a part of. So anyway, wanted to highlight some of these stories as well, so go ahead and check this out.
Hello, I'm Mark Music. This is my wife, Megan. And we are missionaries with Reach Global, currently serving in London, England.
This past year, we've been blessed to have you, River Oaks, come alongside and partner with us as we seek to share the gospel in London.
And we know London may not be your first thought when you think of a mission field, but unfortunately, there's deep spiritual depravity throughout England. And out of the almost 9 million people who live in London, only 4% proclaim to have a personal relationship with Jesus. In our community, the majority of the population is Muslim or Hindu, so we seek to reach these people with Christ through sports ministry and cross-cultural ministry. I coach American football, and I seek to build those gospel-centered relationships to plant seeds and be a light to those who have rarely, if ever, heard about Jesus or attended a church.
My focus is primarily cross-cultural ministry, and specifically sharing the gospel with Muslim women. We moved to London in April, and I am in the early stages of networking with partners and looking to build relationships with women in our predominantly Muslim and Hindu community.
And we've also partnered with a church planting network, and we work with a brand new church plant in this community. I support the church through marketing and communication efforts, while Megan leads a lot of the cross-cultural initiatives. She disciples young ladies in the church and does some women's ministry events in the community as well.
We've seen God move mightily over this past year. We have specifically seen God at work through his provision, financial, visas, prayer partners that all helped us to get to London in April.
We've also seen God at work through his kindness in the way that doors have been opened and he's allowed for these relationships to develop with our new neighbors, those in our community, the players and coaches that I'm working with, and in and through our Reach Global London City team as well.
One specific story we'd love to share is that our Reach Global team was able to partner with a local church who was running a kids camp and needed extra volunteers. We were able to come alongside and serve this church, and we were privileged to see God move amongst Muslim families. Several Muslim families brought their children to this camp as they viewed the church as a safe place for their kids during the school break. As we continue to spend more time with the children and some of the parents, one particular mom began to open up and explain that her family had recently given up their lives in the Middle East to come to London in search of more opportunities and help for their son. She explained that due to her son's autism, the family was mocked, shamed, and shunned by their community and even some family members. Although the parents had a different faith, they felt the church was a safe place for their son and he would be cared for and he would be welcomed and loved. This led to some great conversations with the parents, and they're interested in continuing to bring their son to different things at the church. God is clearly breaking down walls and stirring in the hearts of parents and children throughout our city.
In another way God is moving is he's continuing to allow us to use our story to advocate for missions, especially within the next generation. We've had a few short-term teams from high school and colleges in the States join us here in London over the summer, and we've been able to share our story and help them understand that missions is a mindset, not a location, not a job description. Missions isn't just building wells or bringing Bibles into a closed access country. Missions can be coaching, teaching, business operations, and it was just so exciting to see the students' eyes open up and begin to ask questions and understand that whatever gifts or passions or calling that God has placed in them, that those can be used in their school around the United States and certainly around the world with that missional mindset.
In this next year, we are excited to continue building upon the momentum of this last. God has opened many doors in our short time in London so far, and we're excited to continue building relationships, networking, and supporting the local church in London for the advancement of the gospel. We pray God continues to guide us in this next year and that we walk in obedience to him.
And we would love if you would just join us in praying for the over 8.5 million people who are lost throughout London. And please pray for wisdom and discernment and safety and protection for us as we try to reach them for Christ.
Thank you, River Oaks. We are so appreciative of you and your partnership with us.
Venga, silla de ruedas. y esperando que sea de agrado para ustedes.
Claro que sí. Gracias.
¿Qué tienen este colchón? Para...
Colchón
para que ella pueda...
Para que ella pueda...
Padre, en el nombre de Jesús, Señor, en esta tarde, te damos gloria, honra, alabanza de tu hija de oración, porque tú eres digno de honra y honor.
Mi Salvador, por siempre, no temeré, estás conmigo.
Dios mío, que me rayo.
Oh.
worship on my Spanish. I love that. There's two things that I really love about our church, and one of them is our commitment to trying to reach all people. And that is something that's really, really important to our vision, as Drew touched on. And the other thing is serving and compassion. You guys just saw a glimpse of some of the things that we try to come alongside and partner and do. But one thing about this church, we want to be a church that serves and that reaches the lost for the name of Jesus. Amen? So if you go to River Oaks, if you call this place your church home, the hope is that you are serving somewhere. The hope is that if you're not in a community group, if you're somewhere serving, you're helping, that we want to be a church that is the hands and feet of Jesus. Amen? I'm just going to give you a couple other things, a couple of the other things that we did. So here's one of the other things that you all did. The 13,912 pounds of produce have been produced out of that garden. It's a lot of zucchini. That's a whole lot. That's amazing. 272 kids attended Spring Hill. So that's one of our huge vacation Bible school that we have every year in the summertime. 272 kids attended and heard the good news of Jesus in many different ways. That's awesome. So next year, make sure your kids are a part of that. 665,000 meals were packed at our Packathon. So every around January. Yeah, that's right. We worked with Children's Lifeline to pack all these meals. I don't know why they put that picture. All these meals get shipped to Haiti. So to help so many families down in Haiti who are struggling with food, and you all help to pack so many of those meals. We do that every single year. 6,182 hugs were sent to military personnel. So that's important. So if you don't know what hugs is, hugs are the thing that go around your neck to kind of keep you cool. So a bunch of gift baskets are sent to troops in the military overseas that our group helps to pack every week. 522 shoe gift boxes through Operation Christmas Child were sent to Africa, and each one had the gospel presented in them. So we were able to do that work with a company called Operation Christmas Child. And you guys helped to pack all those gifts that went all the way to Africa to help families who want to do that. 24 projects were done for our fixers, builders, and instructors, the FBI. So those guys did, yeah, that's important. So if you don't know what the FBI is, that's a group of our guys who know how to swing a hammer. Even if you don't know how to swing a hammer, we go in and we help folks build things like fixing windows on their home or building ramps. These guys do that. They need some young blood. So if you know how to swing a hammer and you can do it and not hit your finger, sign up. And also, let me keep going. A couple more things. 50 moms come together regularly to grow not only in their roles as mothers but also as followers of Jesus. We have a moms group that meets every week. Of mothers of small kids who meet and hang out and they talk and they do life together, and it's so important. So 50 moms were able to do that every single week. 9 community groups were launched this past year. 9 of them. We want to grow that. I think our goal is 50 in the next few years, right? So, yeah. These groups are important because this is our way to go out into the community. This is a way for you to find community and also be on mission together. Huge, huge. That's a huge part of our church. And last but not least, one Elkhart campus that was purchased. One building all the way there. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Yep. $1. That's awesome. That God was able to provide. Guys, I'm excited because I feel like there's some awesome things that's going to happen on that block out of that church corner with every one of you all. So if you are part of this church, compassion is the name of the game. Generosity is the name of the game. And being the hands and feet of Jesus is what we are trying to do. Amen. So important. So let's pray. Let's get you out of here. Father God, today is about you. God, it's not about us. We're just vessels. We're just simply doing what you called us to do. God, there are so many people across this nation and across this world who are hearing the gospel, God, because you are igniting a fire through your Holy Spirit to reach people for your name. And God, I just pray that this church continues to do that, that we don't ever step away from compassion, that compassion and showing generosity and being the hands and feet of Jesus is so important. So God, as we leave out of here this morning, let us leave out of here thanking you for what you've done. Not for what we've done as a church, God, but for how you've used us to be your hands and feet. Let us continue to do that into this next ministry year. And God, help us to be one people, one church moving forward for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. And the church said,
amen.
We'll see you next week.